I was using my axe and I wanted to use it to rotate a log, so I whacked it in the end like that and then wanted to twist the whole thing like this, but that turned out to be a dumb idea because the axe handle is not strong in that direction. My first thought was I should make a new axe handle, but then I thought maybe I could use a needlessly complicated method of fixing the old one and demonstrate how smart I am. So my idea is to put a finger joint on the axe handle right here, because that part is actually a lot thicker than the hole in the handle. And the reason the handle is so thick right here is a lot of times you end up overstriking and you whack this part onto the whatever you're chopping. So if I finger joint this piece onto here, that joint should be more than strong enough compared to the part that goes into the handle here. I'll start by adding a flat reference surface to the handle, and that'll help me clamp it into the box joint jig. The hole in the axe head has actually got a slight taper on it for holding the handle. Normally, with the axe head, the handle is inserted like this, and then the wedge is driven in from the top, and that spreads the handle and locks it in like a dovetail. Unfortunately, that means the handle is relatively narrow where it connects to the head, and that makes for a slightly weaker spot. So what I thought I'd do this time is I put the head on backwards and have a tapered handle like so, so it's wider here, and hold it in place with a screw and a washer from the top. To make a tenon to match this hole, I thought I'd use my pantorouter, so I photographed this head on and then printed out 2x size with my big print program using a ruler as a reference, and then I made a template from that for my pantorouter. Quick alignment check with the bit at about halfway through here. The bearing should be level with the template, and if it's on this edge, I'm cutting in here a bit, and on here lining up with the edge of the template, I'm cutting away here as well, so the tenon is centered reasonably well on this piece of wood. Now I still need to taper this a little bit, which I can't really do with this setup, but I will put a smaller follower on here and carve the tip of it again, and that'll sort of start my taper. So now I'll carve that taper with a draw knife. Well, I'm not convinced that that was any faster than just making a new handle, but at least I don't have to varnish it and I didn't have to waste any wood. And as you can see, the joint is way bigger than the tenon that goes into the head, so I'm not at all worried about this breaking before this breaks.